Dracula II, Ascension, and Dracula III, Legacy were really meant to be one long movie, with 3 picking up where 2 left off. Dracula escapes with Elizabeth, and Uffizi lies there defeated, but he promises to catch the creature at all costs. So let's watch Dracula III, Legacy, and see if Father Uffizi was successful. This time, it opens up in Berlin. We see Luke. Yeah, Luke. I'm glad to see he made it. Anyway, Luke is being chased by a vampire. But, yep, you guessed it. Him and Uffizi are working together, with Luke as the bait. They're going around just trying to get a lead on where Dracula's hiding, but no vampire would dare tell them. They pin down one of them to some tracks, and a train comes barreling in, running the vampire over, and cutting off its head. But a small little nitpick here. Why was the train coming in so fast? Look, they're right next to a parked train. The one coming in at high speeds would crash into the parked one. Certainly they would leave some room in between the two trains, which means the vampire wouldn't get hit at all. I know I'm overanalyzing this, but I guess that's just what happens when you watch too many Dracula movies. Uffizi goes back to the church, hoping that they will continue to bless him on his mission. Here's Roy Scheider again. I still can't believe they got him to be in 2 Dracula movies. He tells Uffizi that he's got to stop hunting Dracula. He's worried Uffizi's fallen in too deep, and the darkness in his soul will take over soon. Uffizi doesn't want a full-time job blessing babies, so he quits, opting to fight his enemy without the church backing him. Uffizi and Luke now go to Romania, where they hear the creature of the night is hiding out. But the country is having its own issues. A civil war is breaking out, and no one trusts anyone, making the place feel very unwelcoming. This whole time, Luke calls Uffizi DG, which is a heck of a lot better than the name Uffizi. He later explains that it stands for damaged goods. Just in case you forgot, Uffizi is still fighting the vampirism curse. They drive around looking for evidence of vampires, which isn't too hard. Everywhere they go, they find dead bodies. They see some locals who are having some problems, and Uffizi warns Luke to just drive past them and let them deal with their own issues. But, of course, he has to intervene. Here we learn that these guys are procurers. What do they procure? Human bodies. These are the humans that work for Dracula, daywalkers who can snatch people up and give them to their leader to suck dry. In return for their services, Dracula won't kill him. The guys eventually make it to a village left in ruin. They burn all the bodies, and then a helicopter comes crashing from above. It's a media chopper, and let's just say that the pilot isn't going to make it out of this one. The reporter, Julia, does, however, and Uffizi directs her and her camera guy to the safest place, a church. Luke comes in and recognizes her from her show. She says they came here to cover the Civil War, but they found something else, and that they're way over their heads.
We had no idea.
They watch some footage of the attack, and of course you can't see the attackers, which is pretty cool. Luke fills them in on what they're up against, and I guess they're like, oh yeah, vampires. That makes sense. Julia goes to the graveyard where Uffizi just buried the pilot, and they have a quick funeral for him. They split up, and she returns to the church, where she's attacked by a clown vampire. Yeah, the circus is in town, but it doesn't really amount to much. Just this guy and another one walking on stilts. Both are taken out in their own ways. and the group lives to see the sun rise. Except for the cameraman. He was bitten and killed, but no one cared about him anyway. Julia goes her own separate ways, but I have a feeling that we're going to be seeing her again real soon. As the guys drive around, they once again stop to help the locals. But it was a trap. Man, vampires these guys can handle. Humans, though? Well, that's a different story. Back at the rebels' base, Uffizi says that they share the same enemy, knowing that they're both hunting vampires. At first, the rebels don't believe him, until they see his eyes. They ask how he can walk in the daylight, and he tells them how he's been fighting the infection.
That's impossible. Some days I have to agree.
Julia comes in. I guess after seeing everything she's seen, she's still worried about getting her story. They lock the two guys in a cell, and of course, the base gets attacked. During the fight, Julia is able to get a hold of a key and let them out, so that's good. But Father Uffizi locks her in with Luke, and he fights until morning. Where he goes to get his daily dose of sunlight. But this time, he's not alone. Eventually, the trio make it to Dracula's castle. I don't know what took them so long. I mean, how many castles are there like this out here? They scope the place out, but are caught. Uffizi gets a shotgun blast to the chest, while Luke gets knocked out, and Julia is taken prisoner. The first to wake up is Luke, and he realizes where he is. It's their slaughterhouse. He manages to escape as all the vampires come in, ready to feed. He stumbles upon a room full of TVs. No doubt this is how Dracula keeps up to date on his world politics. Luke hears a voice, and he asks it about Elizabeth, still hoping to save her. Dracula drops down, ready to show him to her. Dracula here is once again played by somebody else, but this time, it's Rutger Hauer. I have to say, I was surprised by this. He plays a good vampire. This movie came out in 2005, just a year after Salem's Lot remake came out, where he played the main vampire Barlow. He's also the lead vampire in Buffy the Vampire Slayer, so I guess he just liked to play the undead. Anyway, he shows, or more like pushes, Luke into a cage full of bloodsuckers. Most of them are topless, so I can't linger on this part for too long. Just know that he finds Liz, but she seems too far gone, and she knocks him out. Uffizi's still alive, to no one's surprise, and he goes into the castle to save the day. But first, Luke wakes up and realizes that Liz isn't worth it. And then Julia comes too as well. Luckily, she's not bitten yet, but it's only a matter of time, because Dracula wants her to be his next wife. Uffizi comes in, but it's just a little too late, for Julia at least, as she's been impaled. Uffizi looks for the one who could have done this to her, and, well, come on, it's Dracula. So he prepares for the final showdown. They fight, it goes back and forth, it looks like Dracula has the upper hand, until Elizabeth shoots a flaming arrow and Uffizi savagely attacks him. He grabs a sword and then cuts the Prince of Darkness's head off, ending the reign of Dracula. Liz then takes the sword and meets Luke out in the hall. She's had enough of this life and asks him just to end it for her. As she prepares for her death, Julia says that she doesn't want to go. Luke walks outside the castle, expecting his partner to follow, but he doesn't. Uffizi has replaced Dracula, and he has Julia at his side forever. Well, that was kind of dumb. I guess it was all foreshadowed in the beginning when the church warned Uffizi that he was getting in too deep. But still, how did he finish off Dracula? I know he got his head cut off, but remember, he was the first vampire, punished by God to never die. I'm sure he's still alive and he'll just grow a new body eventually. I think they were trying to make it look like Uffizi forgave him on behalf of God so that he could die, but remember, the church fired him, so technically he didn't have the right. I don't know, I just didn't really like that ending. Gone is anything referencing him to the Bible. They didn't even bring up that he is Judas, which was the coolest part of this whole entire reboot. I did like the dynamic between Luke and Uffizi though. Their on-screen chemistry worked really well. And then this movie has more action than the others, so if that's your sort of thing, then good for you. I say your best to just watch Dracula 2000 and forget about these sequels. There was a fourth movie planned and even written, but it was never made past that stage, and maybe that's for the best. I give Dracula 3 Legacy 1.5 train car beheadings out of 4.
What does it mean? DG. Damaged goods. It was either that or Buffy.